बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम अस्सलामु अलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इज़ द लेक्चर नंबर 3, द यूज ऑफ द लैंग्वेज एंड द नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन, BBA 2 ऑफ बिजनेस कम्युनिकेशन। टुडे द टॉपिक वी डिस्कस इज दैट द वर्बल एंड नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन। द मैन इज अ सोशल एनिमल, ही लाइव्स इन सोसाइटी विद अदर ह्यूमन बींग, दे शेयर देयर आइडियाज, फीलिंग्स, इमोशंस, ओपिनियंस विद ईच अदर्स थ्रू वर्बल एज वेल एज नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन। वैन दे वॉन्ट टू एक्सप्रेस थाट्स, दे नीड वर्ड्स दैट स्टैंड फॉर देयर थाट्स। वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन consists of the words arranged in a meaningful pattern. They communicate, they can also transmit the messages in spoken words and also in a written form, anticipating that someone hears or reads what they have to say. So verbal communication takes less time than the written one and needs no composing. Given choices, people would rather talk to each other than write to each other. The choices depends on the needs of urgency of the message. If they need immediate response or feedback, they prefer talking. When people communicate orally, they can ask questions and test their understanding of the message. The verbal communication has its drawbacks as well. You have less opportunity to revise your spoken words than written words. Then you cannot cross out what you just said. Furthermore, when a permanent record is needed for future reference, oral communication becomes less important than the written communication, which is also available in the form of the letters, memos, reports and other kind of the written words. So the verbal communication also plays a very vital role. The verbal communication can also be a formal and informal. The informal communication, which is also available in a written form, can also play a very vital role for the enhancement of the business activities and also mutual understanding. Because definitely a such kind of the writings in a form of the letters, in form of the reports, the research paper, thesis and also business reports and also different kind of the letters, in form of the business letter, recovery letters and also adjustment letters, so on. So these are also a very important source of the communication and also generally known as the verbal communication or the use of the language in the communication. Now the other part of the communication, which is generally known as the non-verbal or unspoken communication. So in this way, these are the words which also not spoken but also convey something very important. So that's why some kind of the words which are not uttering but also communicate effectively. So it is also depend on the different kind of the situation and also scenarios, in which three important parts which are generally considered as the way of the non-verbal communication. So on the top of this communication, appearance. So appearance, your physical appearance, your apparent conditions. So role of the appearance in the communication is very crucial, and also it is a very effective source of the conveying non-verbal impression that affects the listeners, readers' attitudes towards the verbal written message even before he hears or reads it. So now appearance is also well affect on the written message, because definitely business letter look good and attractive to the recipient if its overall appearance is impressive. So its appearance induces the readers to pay his full attention to it. it. So first of all, the envelope's appearance tells its urgency or importance to the recipients. Then the design of the letterhead, its format, needs and clean typing, adequately placed sections with proper margin and other form also create good impression on the reader. So appearance also affects in this way indirectly on the written message. So now physical appearance also affects on the oral message, because definitely now the success of an oral message also depends on the suitable personal appearance as well as appearance of the surrounding, because now the personal appearance also affect very accurate your lifestyle, your hairstyle, your makeup, jewelry, neatness, and also station form of appearance, and also spoken words, and also all kind of the ways through which you can also show your appearance. So definitely its affects on this process. So they tell a lot about the habits, professions, age, sex, social status, nationality. So sometimes a small strip or a bandage on the dress gives vent to our feelings. So a black ribbon around the arm of a silent man conveys a non-verbal message. Just such kind of example can also be quoted of a traffic warden who controls the traffic by the signals which are shown by his hands. So body language also affects very well and also become a source of the effective communication. So appearance also has a very deep effect on its surrounding, also conveys its size of the room, well decorations, it also such kind of the things, furniture, floor carpeting, curtains, lights arrangements, also show the person's mood and what kind of the nature he has. So a well furnished office of the executive of a firm impress the visitors and reveals how the firm is getting on. So body language is also the second important unspoken source of the communication. So body language, our body's physical movement is an important part of non-verbal communication. The study of body language is defined as a kinesis. Now the kinesis word is also generally spoken for this. So body language includes facial expressions, gestures, postures, smell and touch. So they are non-verbal symbols which sometimes are more meaningful and forceful than the word. So suppose a teacher asks a student if he has understand the lesson. So because an excellent teacher can also judge by the face impression of the students, either the students understand the lesson fully or not, so even then he can also judge the present situation. So gestures and postures also played a very vital role in this way. So gestures are the unspoken media of the communication. They are the action of our limbs used to reinforce the effect of our words. So often during lectures and discussions, we use gestures to gain the interest of the audience alive. The success of a speech or lecture largely depend upon the effective use of the gesture, because sometimes we have observed that a speaker or a speaker can also tone his dress and sometimes in spoken very emotionally and sometimes in a very low tone, because it also depend on the requirement of the situation, because the emotional words spoken by the speaker always have a very deep effect, and those words which are also spoken in a low tone have a special influence on the audience. So this is also a silent message which can also be conveyed through the gestures and the posture. Sometimes we have already convey something through our body language, the gestures which are shown by our hands and also our talking styles, our body language, and also our walk here and there during the speech while we are also delivering on our situation. So these are also these are the important source which convey something very important. So our body posture also conveys a non-verbal message. So sometimes the smell and touch also play something very important. So we use very some artificial perfumes and fragrances on different occasion and season, to which also convey our emotions, feelings and mood, because definitely now the personality to whom you are also greeting at this spot can also imagine, judge about your personality and also about your taste and what kind of the nature you have and what kind of the perfumes are used by you on the different or the casual situation. So smell and touch also plays a very vital role in this connection. So now the voice is also another important factor of the non-communication. So when we say and how we say is the reflective of our feelings and emotion. The meanings of our word depend to a large extent on our tone. So sometimes we utter in a pleasant form and sometimes we show our silence in a sarcastic tone, and sometimes we show our emotional expressions through our body language, through our voice. Sometimes the real words which are spoken by us convey an opposite message. Silence, time, space and also sounds communicate something, because sometimes when some persons are also show their expressions, show their feelings, emotions and also rage in a silent mood, and some person also show their action at this spot. So silence apparently seems unimportant and meaningless, but sometimes it becomes more adequate and meaningful than the words. So the time also plays a very vital role in this connection. Almost our activities, personal, business, social are subject to a time schedule. We have to arrange our daily activities under a set timetable. We ourselves abide by it and also expect other to adjust themselves to it. In case of an appointment, we expect other to be on time. If we are punctual and we are used to abide by a specific time, and also we hope that now the others to adjust themselves according to the mood and requirement. So when an appointment is ignored, it causes problem and change in attitudes. So to be on time, it also for each day work and for daily life conveys non-verbal messages in our culture. Punctuality by a person indicates his disciplined life and sense of responsibility. Now the space also is another non-verbal communicators, like silence and the time. Space can be used for non-verbal communication. The space message and also space around us and the space we occupy is not meaningless. It gives concrete message. The study of distances individuals maintain between each other in social interaction is called a general word proxemics. Proxemics is a word which also gives a very important message, but in a hidden way and also very quietly. So sounds, speech is the major source of conveying a verbal message. Besides speech, we use many sounds, just like the throat clearing, signing, laughing, to communicate non-verbal message. So non-human sounds of the whistles, bells, siren, steam trains, cars, airplanes also communicate non-verbal message, just like you are also busy in your a very important activity. Meanwhile, a airplane also passing over by your head in a very very piercing sound, so it also gave you a disturbance and you feel unhappy. And also without uttering a word. So this sound of the ringing bell tells the persons that they are free to leave the situation and does not consider it better or in his favor. So verbal and non-verbal communication plays a very vital role to communicate something. So every source of the communication, either belong to verbal or the non-verbal, should be used according to the requirement of the situation, and also it must be used at the appropriate time. Verbal and non-verbal communications are also take place for the enhancement of the business activity, for the development of the mutual understanding and mutual confidence. In this way, these two important sources of the communication play a key role to understand the situation and to expound the situation. Thank you.